Sorry, I had to stop the video for a second. My dog went crazy and had to go find out who was here. Somebody was here. But we're at the brush holder. And the brush holder, you have to be, this is what I want to watch. When you get these brush holders, first you want to make sure that these brushes are loose. I would not just throw a brush holder right in. First thing I do is check the brush holder and make sure that they're loose by pushing a pin through and make sure the brushes are free and moving properly. Then what you want to do, and this is, I've been doing auto electric a long time, it's very important. You want to push this wire back, the wire from the brush. You want to push those back, make sure that they're back. I've seen them where people have installed these brush holders with the wires pushed forward, and what happens as this brush wears out, this wire rubs on the rotor and cuts it in half and will stop your alternator. So you want to make sure that those wires are pushed back and these clips are on properly and that your pin is pushed through the proper way. And then this goes right on top of your voltage regulator. Now here's where the diode trio comes into play. The diode trio fits on the bridge rectifier and goes to the stator, the voltage regulator brush holder assembly. It goes on the bridge rectifier right where the stator would go on. And the purpose of that is when the alternator starts up, the right here at the stator leads, that's AC current, and this little diode trio is converting the AC current to DC current to feed the voltage regulator. So this part of the regulator actually gets a signal and power from the stator. There's also ignition lead on that. So here we're going to put our screws in. Insulated screw goes through right in here at this area where the diode trio goes in. You get that little bugger to go down in there. You screw it down in. Okay, insulated screw at the diode trio. I'm not tightening it all the way up. Now another insulated screw where the other brush is. And get that down in there. Yeah, you can see these things are extremely easy to work on. That's why I say no soldering, no electric tools. You can virtually do these things on a picnic table, in the fender of your vehicle, wherever, back of your pickup truck where you need. Now this screw to the outside, this is the non-insulated screw. So for these 12 volts, you have insulated screw, non-insulated screw. Make sure they're in there in that configuration. And that's down in there. Now the next is going to be the stator. We're going to install the stator. First, you want to do a visual check on the stator and make sure it's in there. It looks good. Everything is in good condition, that the wires are back. You don't want them protruding in so they hit the rotor. You don't want them sticking out so they hit the case. And now stators, this is right from a rebuilder. This is very important. You get the stator lined up in there so that they line up with the screw holes and get that pounded down in there. And now this is very, and then you put your nuts on. Three little nuts, get those on there, and that takes a 11/32 socket and spin those on, get them started. Alright, I'm not going to go all the way super tight with these things, I'm just going to get them started on there. Because I want to show you key important, one of the most important parts, and this is one of the biggest areas of mistake that people make in repairing these 10Si's, these wires back here for the stator lead. The top portion of this bridge rectifier is the negative portion. The bottom portion of this bridge rectifier where the battery post goes through is the positive portion. So whenever they're doing this work and installing a stator, these stator leads can get pushed down. They'll be pushed down like this. And when you tighten the screw down, the back of this stator lead will touch on that bridge rectifier. You have to make sure as you do that, that these stator leads are not touching the back of that bridge rectifier and shorting it out, because the alternator will not work if you do that. So you might have to get in there with needle nose pliers or whatever and push that out to make sure that these three stator leads are not touching that bridge rectifier when you tighten them down onto the bridge rectifier. Once you tighten these things down, you have to make sure, especially if you're installing a new stator, you have to make sure that the wires here are not coming out into the path of the rotor, and make sure that the back of that terminal does not short out on the negative portion of that bridge rectifier. It will not work. And that is the putting the kits in for the respective alternator products. You can see those on our website. Please visit. I really appreciate the business and the opportunity to show you how to do these things. there'll be more videos to come on this series. Thank you.